Browns fans, week 10 is already upon us, so make sure you are subscribed to the channel. Because listen, here's the deal. I'm not saying if you don't subscribe, the Browns are going to lose. I would never wish that evil upon you, Ricky Bobby. But why leave it up to chance? Check that box right now. That way on Sunday, in a close game, if the Browns need a couple breaks their way, you can have a big sigh of relief and go, whew, at least I subscribed. Don't be that guy that doesn't subscribe. And then the Browns, I don't want to say it, but if that happens, you look at yourself in the mirror on Monday. Welcome into the Cleveland Browns Report. I'm your host, Matthew Peterson. On today's show, we have three things we're going to go over. A couple positive COVID tests running around the Browns locker room and the running back room specifically. And then we also have a Wyatt Teller contract extension. He's got a lot of pesos. And then finally, we'll check out the latest AFC playoff picture after Monday Night Football, where the Steelers took a couple pesos to pay off the refs because that was atrocious. So let's kick things off here from Browns beat reporter Cameron Justice. She tweeted this out, confirming that Nick Chubb and Demetric Felton have tested positive for COVID-19. Both are vaccinated, but their status for Sunday is now in question. With John Kelly on the reserve COVID-19 list, the Browns are down to one running back, D'Ernest Johnson. So the big takeaway from right there is that they're both vaccinated, and so that means all they need to get back onto the field is two asymptomatic and two negative tests 24 hours apart. We film this right now, middle of the day, Tuesday. You have enough time to make that happen, but if they do become symptomatic, we hope they get well soon, but it doesn't look like they would be able to play. So I wouldn't call it a long shot just yet. We've seen players get positive tests early in the week and then be able to play on Sunday. It's a coin flip. But here's how the running back room shapes out currently. You got Chubb on the COVID list, Kareem Hunt on IR. The only one available is D'Ernest Johnson. Demetric Felton and John Kelly also hanging out on the COVID list. So there's just one available back. And with no Nick Chubb, we've seen the Browns do just fine. But with Nick Chubb, it's a lot better. He's averaging 6 yards per carry. That's not a typo. 6 yards through 7 games and 6 touchdowns. When he's on the field, he is a monster. But without Nick Chubb, you're looking at this player, D'Ernest Johnson, the fun week 7 story. We'll get his stats up in a moment. But the great comeback story of a guy who had a horrible 40 time. I'm not faster than him, or wasn't faster than him then. But bad 40 time, works his way up. And now he is in the NFL with the Browns. And had a chance to shine in week seven and made the most of it. So before we check out DJ a little bit more, I want to pose this question to you. What's your panic level if Chubb can't play? Scale for me from 1 to 10. I'm going to make this the pinned comment. So if you get hit with the YouTube ad break, go on down, scroll to the pinned comment, reply. When the ad's over, come back up, and I'm going to give you my answer in just a moment. For now, personally, I'm at a 5, and the reason for that is it's still early in the week, so you can't quite rule out the possibility that they won't play, but D'Ernest Johnson did more than fine the week he had to fill in. Look at his week 7 stats against the Broncos on Thursday Night Football. Went off for a 146, 6.6 yards per carry, and a touchdown. Could have had 2, but made the heads-up play and slid down in front of the goal line to run the clock out. So the Browns have shown that you could put anyone in front of this. You could put me, but you could put someone a little faster than me behind that offensive line, and they're gonna do pretty well. So for that reason, I'm at a 5. Although you're playing the Patriots on the road, New England's won 3 in a row. They've won 4 out of their last 5. They are a great team, and you'd like to have all your weapons available. We're going to get to the Wyatt Teller contract news in just a moment, but first I want to tell you about our sportsbook partner, BetUS. They're hooking you up with a 125% deposit bonus. What that means in English, you put $100 in, boom, $225 to play with, and all you need to do is follow 2 simple steps. You go to the link at the bottom of your screen, you plug in the promo code, Browns125, and you are rolling in the dough. You're like the gif of Daffy Duck diving into a pot of gold. That's where you are at BetUS. And we also have a free jersey giveaway. No hoops to jump through, nothing complicated, 4 simple steps. You got to go to chatsports.com/bet. Browns125. Sign up, deposit $100. You get $125 on top of that. Email us jersey@chatsports with your BetUS account number and a screenshot of your first bet. And most importantly, Do you want a Nick Chubb jersey? Do you want a Baker Mayfield jersey? You want it in brown? You want it in white? Let us know the size. Let us know the color. Email us jersey@chatsports.com. We'll get the instructions up one more time. That way you can see everything you have to do. It's super simple. There's nothing complicated about it. So here it is. Take a picture of this slide right now. Get locked in. Be the hero this holiday season when you're giving your loved one a brand new Browns jersey. Free of cost to you, and you get to gamble too. It's a win-win. Moving on, Wyatt Teller. He got paid. He's got a lot of moolah. He has plenty of dough to go around, so everyone Venmo request him. No. He agreed to a four-year, $56.8 million contract extension earlier today. It's worth about just north of $14 million on average per year. That makes him the second highest paid guard in the NFL, excluding some guy who's on a franchise tag, so exclude that. Second highest paid guard in the NFL, and he deserves it. We're going to check out the Browns offensive line numbers in a moment, but this Browns offensive line, they have been flipping pancakes all season long, and it shows. You check out the depth chart here. This offensive line is the best in the NFL. I have nothing to hesitate for me to say that. From Wills, if that's your weakest player and it's just been a little shaky because of some injuries, if that's as bad as it gets, it is a damn good day to be a Cleveland Brown on the offensive line. Now, looking at the contract situation, I think it's important to note that GM Andrew Berry made some has to make some decisions. He's got three out of his five players entering the last year of his contract next season. I don't know if he'll be able to afford to keep all five of these guys back in 2023. Jedrick Wills has a fifth-year option, which would extend him through 2024. But clearly, he loves Teller, so it's up to Joel Petonio, J.C. Treader, and Jack Conklin. Maybe two out of the three. It's unfortunate, but that's the business. Can get the bag and stick around. I'm guessing whichever one of those three just doesn't perform the best or can't stay healthy. Hopefully it's not Conklin. He's been so good when he's on the field, but that may be the difference maker. So time for you guys to get your red pens out. Grade this extension for me. A, B, C, D, or F. Let me know what grade you're giving it. I'll give you my grade in just a second. But first, I want to let you guys have your voice and get in the comment section and let me know. I'm giving this an A++. Every day when I come home for work, I ask my girlfriend, how was the dog while I was gone? And she says, A++. And that's where this deal gets, because Wyatt Teller has been one of the best guards, if not outside of Zach Martin and Quentin Nelson, and his own teammate, Petonio, the best guard in the NFL. Here's the Pro Football Focus grades for the entire offensive line for Cleveland. Joel Petonio, he ranks third out of 76. J.C. Treader, seventh out of 40th. Wyatt Teller, second right there. Conklin, 11 out of 79th. And Jedrick Wills is 59 out of 79. I'm not concerned about that at all. He's still trying to put together a complete healthy season. This ankle injury continues to bother him. But again, if the slowest guy in the relay is ranking 59 out of 79th, that is a great day for the offensive line coach in Cleveland. This offensive line is no surprise when it's one of the best, if not the best in the NFL, and it shows. Week 10 coming up, Browns traveling to Foxborough to take on Bill Belichick and the Patriots. So Belichick has the Browns number. I think there's a bit of a history there. I wonder if Belichick ever coached for Cleveland. So New England opens up 1.5-point favorites. Honestly, I'm a little, like, if I'm a betting man, I am a betting man. I'm not afraid of that number. 1.5 points, that's not a ton for New England to cover or for Cleveland. So I like plus 1.5 is what I'm getting at when I try to land that plane. And that's what the matchup coming up is. And it's big for playoff picture. It is big for the playoff implications. We're going to look at the division standings right now because the NFC North, I've been kind of starting to beat this drum a little bit. I mean, not like Phil Collins beat it, but we're getting to that point. It's a sneaky good division. It's not sneaky. It's just really good. You got the Ravens, who unfortunately should not be 6-2. They should be 5-3. The Colts or the Vikings should have held on and won, and then it would really be a bottleneck. But the Steelers, after paying off the refs on Monday Night Football and stealing a win from the Bears, they're second at 5-3. I have no faith in Pittsburgh. Quote me right now. Zero faith in Pittsburgh. They will find a way to collapse. Browns at 5-4, and then you got the Bengals at 5-4 as well. Here's the overall playoff picture, though. Right now, Cleveland is on the outside looking in. Can you believe they are there with Kansas City currently not in the playoff picture? Well, there's a lot of football left. So they can still make a run for the division. No doubt about that. 6-2 is not out of reach, especially when you play Baltimore two more times in essentially 3 weeks with a bye sandwiching the two games. But a Patriots game, look at that. Cleveland wins, New England loses. You could be flip-flopping right there and put yourself back in the playoff contention immediately. All this playoff talk does have me wondering, though. Will the Browns make the playoffs? Point blank. Y for yes, N for no. Let me know if you are in on the season still for the Browns being a playoff-bound team, or if you are out. If you're out, I would keep your head down because I'm not giving up yet. Come on. It's 5-4, plenty of football left, plus an extra game. So you can always just build that into, well, we still have the extra game, so everything will be okay. Everything will be hunky-dory. All right, well, that will do it for us here on the Browns Report. Make sure you subscribe and follow me on Twitter if you have not already.